that I remember.
I always try to approach the performance from a spiritual state of mind, because that's where you really touch the human soul. It's really about the spirit of the person that's communicating and the people that are receiving it. So I absolutely try to tap into the spirituality of the moment, for sure. That's very important to me.
My mind said I remember her love.
Yes, it's very important for me to have the audience as a part of the experience, because I want to create a moment if I can. To me, it's more interesting if everyone can contribute and there's an exchange. And I think everyone walks away from the experience, you know, being touched. You know, I'm touched by the audience, you know, singing the songs and giving their energy and their voice to the moment. So I think it's extremely important. And I try to involve the audience as much as possible through the whole show. Everybody's Brother is not completely autobiographical. It's a mashup or mixture of my stories and other people's stories. What I wanted to do was give different characters a voice and bring their condition to light and how they've dealt with hardships and moved on. So the drug addiction is not mine, but it's family and community. But what would happen for me, I just underwent a personal change. I became a father myself, which I, you know, purified my thoughts and my spirit, and that prepared me for, you know, a growth in my faith. And so, as I grew in my faith, I began to be more involved in the community and the church, and that's how I became a Sunday school teacher. It's not necessarily a bad Cody, it's a good Cody. It's just a human evolution, you know, the maturity that we all hope that we can attain as human beings. As I said, my children had a major impact on my growth and my desire to grow in my faith. All those things begin to shape the way that I saw things and the way that I began to think about life and my worldview. So it was a natural evolution for me, you know. And I think as you grow, there's a saying, when you know better, you do better. So I got to a point where I just knew better, so I made better choices. You are what you think, you know. So my thoughts became a lot clearer and more focused. The energy of my music shifted along with my thoughts. So absolutely, I completely grew. My music grew as I grew as well. Well, black music today, it's, as I would describe it, it's in the mainstream, it's lost a lot of the spirit that created the earlier music from the black tradition, the church tradition. There's a spirituality and feeling about it that I believe has kind of been pushed aside for just sonic appeal, you know. But it's still alive, you know. People are beginning to bring that feeling back, and that's what I was attempting to do with Landing on 100, to bring the feeling back. Because when you think about black music or soul music, there's a feeling about it. And in essence, it's just something that stirs, you know, the human spirit, something that you feel on a deeper level. And that's really the best way I can describe it. That was, you know, me all alone recording music on a four-track cassette in my bedroom, just using just the basics to capture a moment, you know, which is, in my opinion, a great accomplishment. I could get the songs out and people could feel the songs the way that I heard them in my head. Landing on 100 is me sharing the creative process with other people. I recorded the album with a 9-piece band, the same band that I'm performing with now. So that was the biggest difference. Also, the orchestration, the fidelity also, you know, I used a major studio 2-inch tape instead of, you know, 4-track cassette. So it was the creative contribution of others and a larger recording facility and more expansive compositions to the songs. I believe artists now can record their music and distribute it through the internet if that's what they want. I believe they can sustain a career that way. It may take a bit more work, but I believe it's possible. So to me, it just all comes down to a choice. The industry is ever changing. You know, the major record companies right now, I think they're trying to hold on to you know, their conventional ways, but it's shifting very fast. So it's really the power is coming back into the hands of the artists, which I think is a great thing. The major standouts for sure, Marvin Gaye, Stevie Wonder, Michael Jackson, Donny Hathaway, Bill Withers, Curtis Mayfield, Sam Cooke, you know, those are like, Al Green, those are like the building blocks, you know. We grew up on those songs, and once again, talking about the feeling, you know, nobody could give you a feeling the way those records did, you know, so those are some of the main ones. I definitely hold in high esteem. And more recently, that's really moved me was the Fela Kuti, you know, because I wanted to become more spiritually conscious and active with my music, and I think he's a great example of how to do that. So I've added him to the list in the last couple of years. Yeah. I really try to find that new moment, that new living moment each night, because to me, that's what lasts. That's what you take away and reflect upon, and that's what you like to keep with yourself. So that's what I hope to accomplish nightly.
That's it! We give it to anybody that's really moving forward and is hoping we're trying to make some people.